Good morning students, welcome to the virtual classroom. We are studying it as in chapter number 5, states of matter. In it we are studying it as in gas laws. We already studied the gas laws as Boyle's law, Charles law and Galusek's law. The next one today we are going to study and that is Avogadro's law. Now particularly Avogadro's law, that is for the molecules, that is number of moles. We have already studied it in our first chapter also, Avogadro's number 6102 into 10 raised to 23. The same factor we are going to over here, but we are going it for the gases molecules and we are going to relate it with volumes. So it is to this at present we already know it that the volume occupied by any gas at constant temperature and pressure is directly proportional to number of molecules present in the gas. It indicates that the volume occupied by any given component, any given gas, maybe hydrogen, helium, oxygen, nitrogen, whatever it may be. If the number of moles are fixed, that is number of the molecules of the gaseous components are fixed, then the total volume occupied by it at a constant temperature and pressure are always same, right? That means if one mole of an hydrogen gas is taken at 25 degrees Celsius or 1 atmospheric pressure, the volume occupied by it will be same as 1 mole of an oxygen gas. Hydrogen gas and oxygen gas, both of them are having a size difference or mass difference, but still the volume occupied by them will be same. So it is indicated as V is proportional to N. V is equals to K by N. Right? Okay. But at the same time, we want to understand the second term also. Constant temperature and pressure means what? For the gaseous components. For the gaseous components. We studied it at constant temperature pressure in the terms of STP. STP means what? Standard temperature and standard pressure. What is the value of standard temperature? Standard temperature is taken as 0 degrees Celsius, that is 273 Kelvin. It's a fixed for any given gaseous component. STP means standard temperature will be always taken as 0 degrees Celsius, that is 273 Kelvin. In the same way, standard pressure means we will be having it as an 1 bar, which is also termed as 1 into 10 raised to 5 Pascal, or in a smaller unit of CGS it is termed as 760 torps. Right? So standard pressure for gaseous component, it's a fixed 1 bar or 760 torp. Standard temperature, that is 0 degrees Celsius to 273 Kelvin. So if I say it as 1 mole of a gas at STP occupies the volume is known as standard volume and its value is 22.7 liter per mole. Now if it is 1 mole fixed, that means the number of the molecules at STP are fixed, 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 molecules. Then what we will be getting it, the volume occupied by it will be 22.7 liter per mole. Right? Now this is for the gaseous components. We got it as for 1 mole. But at the same time, I want to go for the relation between the mass and molecular mass of the given component density. Then how can we convert this equation? So for that case, if I want to convert that equation,
for the relation between the density. Can I write it as n is number of moles, and number of moles means mass upon molar mass, which we symbolized it as m upon capital N, right? Now let us substitute the value in the given equation. What we will get it, V is equals to, sorry, here it's a KN, sorry. V is equals to K M upon capital M. Let's take it as an capital M. We get it as K into small m upon V. This is mass by volume. We know it as mass by volume. That is equals to density. So can I write it as K is equals to M is equals to K into D. This is the proportionality. So can you write it as molecular mass is directly proportional to its density. So the same equation shows us the relation between the molecular mass and the density of the given compound, right? So molecular mass is directly proportional to the density, right? Now after studying these four laws, that is Boyle's law, Charles' law, Kelusic's law and Avogadro's law, now we can say that those which obeys Boyle's law, Charles' law and Avogadro's law, then those gases are going to act as an ideal gas. Now what is the meaning of an ideal gas? When you are having it as an Boyle's law, Charles' law obeyed by them, Avogadro's law is obeyed by them, then why we consider them as an ideal gas? Now what is the specific characteristic of an ideal gas? Ideal gas, when you are taking it, they don't have any kind of an intermolecular forces acting between them. They are completely free to move. No effect of any external factors on it, right? So those components are considered to be as an ideal gas. How can we find out for the ideal gas that equation? Then we want to go it for ideal gas equation. We told it that according to Boyle's law, pressure is inversely proportional to volume. Let us take it in the relation of the volume so that it becomes much easier for us. Volume is proportional, inversely proportional to the pressure. P is inversely proportional to 1 by V, or V is equals to 1 by P, right? Now according to Charles' law, V is proportional to T, right? I want it as an all the volume, so I have taken it as an V. Now third law, according to Avogadro's law, we wrote it as V is proportional to N. And we told that if these three laws are obeyed by any gas, then they are considered to be as an ideal gas. So let's consider that the gas obeys it. Then what we will get it? V is proportional to NT by P. Let's take the P on the other side. So PV is equals to, PV is proportional to NT. If I remove this proportionality sign, I'm going to put it some proportionality constant, which I'm going to indicate it as R. It's a known as gas constant or proportionality constant. This is particularly for the gases component. So we also termed it as gas constant, right? So this gives me an equation, PV is equals to nRT. Now, as we have seen it, if we take it as an initial temperature pressure, if initial temperature pressure volume are taken as P1, T1, P1, V1 respectively, and final temperature pressure, volume are taken as T2, P2, V2 respectively. Then what will we get it? Substitute it. Initially we will get it as P1 V1 is equals to NRT1. That means P1 V1 upon T1 is equals to NR. Right? This is the initial terms. Same way, if V2 put it as a final, P2 V2 is equals to NRT2. So P2 V2 by T2, that is also NR. From this first and the second equation, if we compare these two equations, can we write it as P1 V1 upon T1 is equals to P2 V2 upon T2, because both of them are representing the NR values, that is a constant. So we get the equation as P1 V1 upon T1 is equals to P2 V2 upon T2. This is known as combined gas equation. Why we term it as a combined gas equation? See, we got it as a combination of the three laws, Boyle's law, Charles' law and Kelly's law. And that's the reason why we consider this as a combined gas equation. Right? This is known as an ideal gas equation. Both these equations we are going to use it for number of numericals to be solved for it. Right? Okay. But at the same time, we got it, the gas constant R. Here the number of moles are fixed, but this is R. R is a gas constant. It can be a variable from gas to gas? No. Again, its a value is constant. Then how to get that value of that gas constant R? The value of gas constant R can be derived from the ideal gas equation itself, from the given equation, because we already know it. What are the standard temperature, pressure, volumes under the standard conditions? So, value of this value of gas constant R, it will change depending upon the unit that we are going to calculate for it, right? We terms to terms, units, unit to unit, the value of gas constant will change. So we will derive the different values for 2-3 different units so that you can understand that how these values will be changing. Like for PV is equals to NRT, this was a gas equation, ideal gas equation. We know it, standard pressure, that is 1 bar, right? Standard volume, that is 22.71 liters per mole. N, that is 1 mole. T, that is 273 Kelvin. R, we want to calculate it. So, if I put it as an R as a subject, we will get it as PV by NT. P is what? 1 bar. Right? V, 22.71 liter per mole. These are the unit, liter bar per mole for PV. For N, we get it as 1 mole. Right? And T we are going to get it as we took it as a liter, and this T is 273, that is in terms of Kelvin. So if I take this calculation, I'm going to get it as 0.0831 liter bar per mole Kelvin. The unit I'm going to get it for the RS on the calculation of this term, liter bar per mole Kelvin. Right? But at the same time, I want to convert this unit. So can I say it as 1 liter bar, right, per mole Kelvin. This is 0.0831. I want to convert this bar into Pascal. Then we are having it as a relation, 1 bar 10 raised to 5 Pascal, right. We are having that relation. So I want to convert this liter bar into liter Pascal. So what we will be getting it? 1 bar is equal to this much. So 0.083. How much? So what will be getting it? 0.0831 into 10 raised to 5. The unit will become liter Pascal per mole Kelvin. That is 8.31 into 10 raised to 5. 3. 8.31 into 10 raised to 3 liter Pascal per mole Kelvin. Right? Similarly, we know it as 1 bar. We will be having it as 1 Pascal. That is equals to 10 raised to 3 joules. 10 raised to minus 3 joules. 1 Pascal, that is equals to 10 raised to minus 3 joules. Right? So 8.31 Pascal will become as 8.31 into 10 raised to 3 liter Pascal per mole Kelvin will become as 8.31 joule per mole Kelvin. The unit will see as the unit changes, the different units, their values of R has to be changed. So that means for the numericals, whenever you are going it for the calculation, you have to check what are the units of the pressure that is given to us, whether it's given to us in the terms of bar, Pascal, whether you have been given to us in the terms of joules to calculate the energy change, then accordingly the value of R has to be changed. Right? So that is the factor that we want to remember, the value of R. Right? Okay. Now this is what we did it for the value of R. We got it as in different values, and these units as well as the values of the R under the different units are there to be remembered. They will not be giving us in your exam, they won't give you the values of these R. You will have to learn it and you have to do it by yourself. Right? Whenever they want to round it off and they want to give it to you the value to specifically calculate on basis of it, then they might give you. Otherwise, you have to learn the values of R. Right? Gas constant has to be learned. Okay. Next theory we are having it. That is relation between the pressure and density. We want to go for pressure, density, molecular mass. We already studied it as Avogadro's law also, the density. But now we want to study it completely for an ideal gas. So that means what we are going to do it is PV is equals to nRT, but n is equals to mass upon molar mass, that we write it as small m upon capital M. Substitute the value in this given equation, PV is equals to M upon capital M RT. So this is now one of the new equation that will be used by me for numericals. Right? We will be using it, this one of the equation for the numericals. At present we are going it for something different, but I got it as mass molar mass relation. So PV is equals to M by capital M RT. This can be used for the numericals. But now we will substitute the value over here. So P is equals to M by V RT. But what is it? P is equals to rho RT by M. P is equals to rho RT by M. Let's take it as an on the other side. We will be getting it as P into M by RT. That is equals to rho. If I want to calculate the density of any given compound, can we calculate it as P into M RT into rho, right? Okay, thus we made it as a subject as a density. From the given equation, if I make it as a subject of molar mass, we will be getting it as rho RT by P. If I make it as a subject as a molar mass, then we get it as M is equals to rho RT by P. So depending upon the question that has been asked, we will be using it as a different equation to calculate the given unknown term, right? Okay, but from this, now same to this, we got it as one of the multiple choice question where the students, majority of the students are making an error when this type of multiple choice question is asked. What is that multiple choice question that we are having it? Which one of the following represents the ideal gas equation? Which of the following represents the ideal gas equation? They write it 1, 2, 3, maybe this, maybe this. What does it make a difference? All of them are ideal gas only. And in the one option, they will put it as all of them. Students generally write the answer as PV is equals to nRT. Make it sure that you don't write it as PV is equals to nRT, because additional to that also, we are having it as an equation. Only the terms are changed, subjects are changed, right? Number of moles are changed as mass upon molar mass, but it represents the ideal gas only. So make it sure that all these formulas are known to you, because based on all these formulas, we will be having a numericals to be done, right? Okay, numericals, we will do it in our next lecture. We will do it all the numericals of particularly for the gas laws of Boyle's law, Charles law. We already did it, Galusek's law, we already did it for ideal gas equation, combined gas equation and density. We will do the numericals in our next lecture. Till then, thank you.